Sri Lankan twins, Nadia and Natalie, took an aggressive approach on The Amazing Race, and it failed them twice. Now they're looking to take on their biggest adventure yet and go all the way.
And help it bring it home, finally, third time's a charm for us.
On Amazing Race, we had all the basic needs. You take away all the basic needs, and that's survival.
We'll have sleepless nights, empty bellies.
Survival's gonna be way harder than Amazing Race.
Let it catch, Nadia, do that.
No, you don't leave. Our blood is thicker than anybody else's blood out here. I can guarantee you that. Because the longest I think we've ever been apart without seeing each other was like 2 weeks.
We need help! I can understand if you're lifting a log to bring it over here, but just in the morning, that's only 50 pounds. So you're squatting 50 pounds. You think that's a big deal, bro? It's not a big deal.
Unapu, getting your first look at the new Coyopa tribe. Nadia voted out at the first tribal council. Natalie, is this one of the first times you've truly been without your sister?
Yeah, truly, yeah.
What does that feel like?
I told everybody I haven't cried in like 10 years.
Really? Not a tear in a decade?
I never cried.
Is the emotion more for your sister that she's out or for you that you're alone?
It's just really hard. Because, you know, there is people here that have been together, you know, 5 years, 6 years. Me and Nadia have been together for 28 years. It's just really hard.
All right, the game moves on. You good to go?
Yeah.
She's as big of a badass as you are.
Right.
She's perfectly fine.
Right.
Yeah. Okay.
You can remind yourself that it's a game, but it's still your family. If it was your dude, you'd probably be like,
yeah.
All right. Yeah. But it's your sister, so.
Yeah. Oh, Nadia got voted off. She's probably fine. It's just that we're not together. That's probably the hard part. Now it's just like really good motivation for me to keep my head in the game and just play hard so that I can just at least go as far as I can.
Next matchup, Natalie gonna take on Val.
Yeah, Val.
See this for Nadia, Nat. Let's see it.
Coyopa leads 2-1. Survivor's ready. Go! Natalie comes out hard. Has Val down.
Recover! Recover and push her legs out.
Val fighting back now. Now it's Val who has Natalie on her back.
Stay low, Natalie.
Push your back low.
Val slowly moving Natalie toward the end.
Go, slow roll. Slow roll.
Natalie is not moving.
Choke hold.
Let's go, Val. Fight.
What's going on, Natalie?
Drag, Natalie back up. Now she's got Val on the end.
Now, Natalie. Now. Go.
Yeah, Natalie pushing. Almost got her in.
Alert.
Val goes in. Natalie scores. We are tied. 2-2. Huge battle.
Sorry, Val. Damn, Jeremy's our top best one.
Stuff right when I fall asleep.
We're all working here, so sorry I'm working on your sleeping space. What have you done today, June? Tell me one thing you've done. Watch us leave and just hung out the entire day while everybody else was working.
All right, Natalie, I heard you. I got it.
I don't understand how you come out here and you're with total strangers and you don't feel the need to just pull your own weight. Drew is just a waste of space.
Unapu wins immunity for the third. Straight time!
Change it up, folks! You guys are getting rid of all the strongest people! Change it up!
Hey, Mal, hey, Mal.
I'm talking to you!
Don't worry about it.
Following a
don't
racist?
Don't worry about it. Hey, Mal, save it.
That's fortunate.
Yeah, right back at you.
Hey, Dad, we're a good girl.
Classy, Natalie.
He's a soldier.
Very
classy girl. I like it.
Yeah.
Good
way
for you.
To bring the class,
good
Natalie.
For you.
He talks about W's. He lost against her. He lost
it.
Against Ajon. And still he's sitting there comfortable.
Runner mouth.
So vote against him tonight, guys. Just do it. Just vote him out. Get together and vote him out.
If you were a man, I would knock your teeth out.
Oh,
you look
my
like
God.
A man.
You can knock me out, bro. Knock me out. I'm not scared of you, bro. I'm not scared of you.
Just
like the other
back.
Guys in the tribe. I'm not scared of you.
I was just talking to Drew, and he was like,
The girls are trying to get the guys out. I said,
Drew just said that?
And I said, that's messed up. I'm telling you, they're so dumb. He told me. Me, you,
he just told you that.
He just told me that. I said, there's no guy-girl thing here.
There's
we have no power.
Thing.
That's straight up what I told him. Drew, he's scared the girls are going to vote out guys, which is stupid. We don't even have the numbers to do that, but he's convinced of this girl-girl alliance. Luckily, the guys are kind of a mess, you know. They're not on the same page, which is good. In the long run, who's winning immunity challenges?
I know. Drew or John.
Probably Drew more than John.
Yeah. Well, maybe we get rid of Drew first.
Yeah, I think you're right. Getting rid of Drew, that would be so sweet if we can pull this off. He's so annoying, but we have to do it now while the guys are all over the place.
Fourth person voted out of Survivor Blood versus Water. Drew. Four, that's enough. Need to bring me your torch.
Good job, guys. Good play. Good play, girls.
Whoever you send to exile will not get to take part in eating this reward.
I've been giving this a lot of thought, and I just kind of feel like Julie's been doing so great out here, and it would give her a chance to show John just how much she can really deal with.
I was going to volunteer.
Interesting. You want Julie, and Natalie's offering to go.
I know Julie has provided. She's fought out here.
I mean, I have, but everybody else has too. So.
I haven't.
All right, Reed. You have one person you want to send and one person who wants to go.
Quite frankly, if Natalie wants to go so badly, I'm not going to stop her. So, Natalie, suit up.
Natalie, come on
Thank
down.
Thank you, Natalie.
Okay.
Thank you, Natalie.
Good job, Reed.
I'm doing a good job.
All right, Natalie, Baylor, you will head to Exile Island. You will return in time for the next immunity challenge.
I hope we don't get lost.
Thank you, Natalie.
Bye.
Love you, Bay.
Bye. All right, let's find this tent. Where is it?
I don't know.
Me making this move to volunteer to go to Exile, I hope it plays in my favor. Once I merge, this will prove to Missy and Baylor, like, listen, we need to take care of Natalie if she's not taken care of. Are we supposed to be talking strategy like other people do on Reward? We're just eating. There's no real alliance between anybody here. It's kind of like Jeremy and me on one side and Reed, Keith, and Wes on the other side. You know, if we had Missy or we had John over here, we would be strategizing the entire time.
I don't trust John.
He's sneaky.
Tomorrow it's going to be very clear.
Either very clear or very shady.
No,
yeah.
Yeah.
Here we go. Survivor's ready. Go.
Let's go, girl.
Long as long.
Jacqueline has the reach. If she can use it to her advantage.
That's
go,
not.
Jackie.
Yeah, bend your knees.
Jacqueline trying to push Natalie off now. Jacqueline goes for it. Doesn't work. Jacqueline goes in the mud first. Yellow scores and leads. 2-0.
I have a question about if we can trade positions with the member on there.
You want to give up your reward? You can give up your reward.
Can I choose somebody on that team and switch?
You can give it whoever you want to.
Okay. I want to give my position up for John.
Switch.
I want to give my position up.
To who?
To Jack.
Are you guys kidding me?
Oh my God.
Jacqueline, come on over. John, come on over.
Thank you so much, Jeremy.
Wow, crazy trade.
Oh my God.
Natalie, explain this to me. That's a massive trade on day 22 when food is so hard to come by.
At Tribal Council, I was really nervous about what was going to go down. And when somebody shows you that they're loyal to you, I feel like the only thing to do is to show back just some love and respect.
Thanks so much.
All right.
I just wanted to do this so that he knew that I appreciated him siding with us last night at Tribal, but also just to make sure that moving forward, I could always count on Jacqueline and John to trust me and Jeremy, and, you know, this is going to be leverage for me down the road.
Oh, John, he's with you for life now. He was almost crying.
He was.
Him and Jacqueline both.
I'm telling you, John got that idol. I'm telling you, Nat, I looked everywhere on that thing. He definitely has it.
whatever. Yeah, John is trying to like take control of everything.
You're the only one I trust here. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
You're the only one I 100% trust.
I don't trust nobody else. I don't trust John. I'm telling you, John's trying to set it up right now.
Yeah.
Eighth person voted out, the second member of our jury, Jeremy. Need to bring me your torch.
Oh my God, talk about a blindside. It sucks because I had Jeremy as my partner. It was really hard for me, but I just had to put on like a good face and just try and figure out what to do next.
Another reason for why this happened?
Yeah.
I have an idol. I found it on Exile. And I wouldn't have shared this information with you unless I still trusted you and everything's still the exact same.
It was definitely John in charge of the whole blind side. And, you know, I want to give John a little bit of a taste of his own medicine. I want to do it for Jeremy. It's just figuring out the right plan and the right moment.
Natalie's right behind. Natalie has the final key.
We take all three.
No, we're not going anywhere. We're going to look for the damn item.
Right now?
Yes, while they're gone.
Sure that they don't already have it? Keith doesn't already have it with Wes?
No, there's another one. They didn't get the second clue, girl. Okay, let's figure this out.
I'm like ready to go get water, and Allie's like, what are you doing? We're going to look for this idol right now. I was like, oh shoot, okay, let's go.
It's like literally the heart of our camp by the fire. Oh my God, oh my God.
Shut up,
shut up.
Shut up.
Oh my God. We went berserk. We're like literally out of our minds. We pick up the pots and we run to the water well as fast as we have ever done in our life.
Oh.
So exciting.
Oh my God.
Oh, it's awesome. This is the idol. So sick. Finding it was exactly how you think it'll feel, you know? Just like you're so elated, so excited. It's like my little twinnie. It's just me and my, you know, friend out here. I think we keep making John feel really comfortable for one more vote.
Yep.
Also, Reed is very, very scary.
Yeah.
So we have to all be on the Reed plan. We just get rid of one of the boys so that if we even out, the guys can take us out one by
yep.
one. I want John out bad. But we have to get rid of one more boy before John because that allows us to take out John and still have a majority girls. So we get rid of Reed first.
We all vote Reed.
Yeah. Bill has become my number one. We and her are on the same page as far as we have to get rid of Reed because he's really good at immunity challenges. And all he does is make up stuff so that the target's off him and it's on other people. Reed is so scary.
I know he is.
Ew.
That was unfortunate.
God, I can't spit. Is any more food coming out or no?
You're telling me after 3 hours of battling for immunity, now you'd take some food and step down?
He doesn't look like he's going to come down. If I'm going to come down, it's going to be for some food, not for anything else.
Wow.
All right, pizza, some wings, one cookie, I'm good. And just a glass of water, some ice water.
All right.
Oh, my God, you're hilarious.
So here's the pizza, chicken wings, cookie, water, beer, and here's the necklace. Just because you asked for it doesn't mean you have to take it. It is still your decision.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, seriously. If I'm gonna fall out after 3 hours, I might as well eat something, you know?
Up to you, Natalie. Natalie steps out and immediately crumbles.
What a perfect day.
It's like a perfect reward for us to enjoy together.
Riding horses was amazing. We got to see like Nicaragua from another view. We weren't stuck on a beach anymore and we were just taking it all in.
It was absolutely magnificent. I don't think I'll ever forget, you know, the experience. Final three with me, Bale, and Missy would be a hand-picked team for me to go to final three with. I would be a sure win, in my head. I mean, anything can happen, but I would be completely comfortable going to final three with them.
You want a spin of brownie?
Yeah, no, I want a full one.
She
Jacqueline dropped out. Natalie wins reward.
Good job, Nat.
Good job, Boo.
Good job, Natalie.
Natalie, come on over. All right, big reward for Natalie. First thing you have to decide, who are you going to send to Exile Island?
Exile will be out.
No hesitation.
You know, it's whatever. I figured it was coming. Not really surprised.
Alec, here's a map to Exile. You will return in time for the next immunity challenge.
All right, cool.
Good luck, Alec. Hang
in there.
Find some crabs.
All right, Natalie, big reward.
Yeah.
King-size bed. Food delivered. Invite one person to join you.
I'm going to have to go with Jacqueline.
Hey,
she talks about spaghetti more than anybody else.
It is a king-size bed. You think you could fit another?
Yeah.
All right, invite one more.
John.
Oh, my God.
I was going to say maybe John and Jacqueline alone, but...
We're being freaky tonight, guys.
I've been wanting to get John out ever since he voted out Jeremy. So picking Jacqueline and John for the reward just showed that I'm such a loyal person and they would trust me even more. So that when I take my revenge, he'll never see it coming. John is always bringing up any excuse to talk about wine or how he wants to, I don't know, be some kind of wine specialist in the future and move to Vegas and I don't know what it is. But he is always trying to pretend like he knows everything and the arrogance or the entitlement John has. Honestly, every time he talks about wine, I just want to like be like, shut up. It was torture, basically. He told me that he found an idol on Exile. It's amazing because I've become like the best friend now for him. So getting John out now is really important. I just have to figure out how to do all this, and if I could pull it off, that would be amazing. John is very confident. He thinks that it's going to be a really easy cakewalk to the final three because he's got Missy around his finger. He thinks that Baylor is not going to do anything to mess up her mom's plans. He's got his girlfriend wrapped around his finger, and he thinks that I'm just going to do whatever he wants. Like, he's such a little punk.
Gosh. Yeah.
The thing is, even though he's obnoxious, John's played a really good game. So the more and more I'm thinking of the jury, I'm like, why risk even going to final three with somebody like John? Because if he wins, I would literally kill myself. Keith, don't worry about me. You know, I'm smarter than I look sometimes. Right now, the plan is split votes. Me, John, and Jacqueline are voting for Keith. But if I flip and Keith and I both vote Alec, Alec would go home instead. That way, Keith's still here. He'll be loyal to me, and I can use him to blindside John.
So who are you going to vote tonight?
I guess I'll vote for Alec. Hell, I don't know.
If I do this and betray John, it would be my biggest move yet. The only scary thing for me then is dealing with everything when I come back to camp because John's going to be really pissed. The thing is, I don't know if it's even worth it, me getting in trouble with my alliance. So I'm going to have to make a decision, I guess, tonight. Ultimately, it's just deciding if I have the balls or not. Keith is still kind of unpredictable, but I told Keith he was basically here because of me. I told him that me and Baylor, at the end of the day, have his back. Hopefully that will resonate with him, and he would be a perfect person to use in a plan against John.
And then you'll eat spa food, seared steak,
ooh,
cookies, brownies.
Ah! Steak and brownies, that's what I want.
All right, Keith, Missy, Baylor, you are the threesome now in charge of deciding who goes to Exile Island. You know how this works. You can send anybody you want. You just have to agree.
I can handle it. I can handle it.
No, it's
once
fine.
Again, a volunteer.
Sure,
yeah,
not.
That's fine. I'm good. I'm fine, trust me.
Natalie.
All right, Natalie, you know the way. Head to Exile. You will return in time for the next immunity challenge.
Love you, Nat.
I volunteered to go to Exile, but at this point in the game, when your body's already so drained and it's so close to the end, you can almost taste it, but you're not there yet. It's been, you know, really depressing being out here. It's been really a roller coaster of emotions for me because this is the longest I've gone without seeing or talking to my sister.
I've lived with Nadia for 28 years. We've never done anything alone. And I never let anybody see how much I miss her. I never cried in front of anybody. And I kind of always just pretend like I'm fine, but Nadia has been gone for like 30 days now. And no, I've been kind of doing this without her. But I'm just trying to make it into something where I can, use it as motivation instead of just bringing me down. It's time to, you know, buck up and make every decision moving forward count. I have one shot to prove to myself that, you know, I left everything on the table and make these last 4 days fully worth it. Here, eat this now. Okay. Start eating now. Oh my God.
Natalie, what did they just hand you?
Some rice. And I'm happy that they brought it for me. It was probably like one of the hardest things I've ever had to do. Like I cried probably 50% of the day and it was just exhausting emotionally and physically for me.
And just like that, John drops. Natalie wins.
Okay.
Individual immunity guaranteed a spot in the final five.
Can I give you a hug?
That was quick.
Yeah. The wind, I didn't even move it.
Good job.
Wow.
That's up.
Natalie, come on over.
Good job, Nat.
Make exiles so worth it.
After 35 days, you go to tribal council tonight. You cannot be voted out of this game. As for the other five of you, somebody is going home tonight. You will become the sixth member of our jury. Grab your stuff, head back to camp. See you tonight at tribal.
Nice job, Nat.
Congrats.
Nice job,
Nat. 12th person voted out and the sixth member of our jury. John, that's two. That's enough. Need to bring me your torch.
See you on the other side.
No hard feelings, guys.
All right, John.
Nice move, bud.
Good.
Get to your
Good, John.
Natalie. After her sister Nadia was the first person voted out, she had only herself to rely on. It gave her the courage to make big moves. And with an idol in her pocket, she's not done yet.
When Nadia got out, lit a fire on me that I was like, I'm going to get it, and I'm going to get it for Nadia, for myself, just to prove to everybody else that I'm the best one out here. I basically have two decisions at this point. Missy and Baylor feel like I'm definitely going to be with Missy and Baylor. But I could decide to go with Keith and Jacqueline and say, let's get one of these girls out. Let's try and make it happen.
That's exactly right. That's how it's supposed to be.
I have an idol for myself tonight if I don't win immunity. But the advantage is basically going to help Keith in the next immunity challenge. Totally sucks that he got it because he's going to be the hardest one to beat. I know that I'm safe to the next round, so it is a big decision on who goes home tonight.
Hey, let's win.
So what would you do today, Baylor first?
I feel like Missy, just because I feel like Baylor does whatever her mom tells her.
I mean, listen, I feel really secure with Missy and Baylor. Like, I trust him 100%, but at the end of the day, they're blood.
Hey, I was thinking tonight, if you're going to play your idol, right?
Yeah.
Because you have to. Play for my mom. I don't think you need to play it for you, honestly.
Okay, that's fine. I know I'm in the final four because of my idol. I also, know that Missy and Baylor probably won't vote me off because they feel confident. We're so tied. We trust each other. But what if people... No, I guess nobody's going to vote for me.
Because, I mean, no one's
Keith,
voting for
Keith's,
you.
That's kind of...
Keith's not going to vote for you. He's going to vote for Jacqueline with us.
Oh, okay. Everybody's on Jacqueline.
Everyone's on Jacqueline, and Jacqueline's probably going to vote Missy.
One thing's for sure. Big moves do win this game, and I feel like I've done moves that haven't been as impactful as I'd like, but it's not about anybody else at this point. I'm just thinking about myself.
If anybody has a hidden immunity idol and you want to play it, now would be the time to do so.
Yeah. I guess time to get the idol out of the bag. So I was going to play this for myself tonight. But idols are more fun when you play them for somebody else. Jacqueline, did you vote for who I told you to vote for? I'm playing this for Jack.
Okay. I knew I liked her.
We're going home. Love ya.
This is a hidden immunity idol. Any votes cast for Jacqueline will not count.
my God.
Oh, my God.
Eggs, bread, champagne.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Pineapple, mango.
Oh, my God. Is that cheese?
I've actually learned a lot about myself. The fact that I was able to navigate through this without the one comfort I've had my entire life, which is Nadia, and I was able to do this on my own, makes me really proud.
Chica.
And I know my parents will be proud too, because they feel like we can't do anything without each other. Final three, baby.
Yeah, cheers. Woo!
Now I need to really work through what I'm gonna say to the jury. I don't wanna leave having any regrets about this final tribal.
Amazing. Oh, my God.
I can't leave anything up to fate. I got to do the jury's job for them. I got to make them see why they need to pick me and why I deserve to be the sole survivor.
That.
You know, the longest I've been apart from Nadia is probably a week and a half, and it's been 36 days. I haven't heard from her, talked to her. Oh, my God, if I caught her. Oh, seen her. And I feel like even though I didn't get to play with Nadia, I think the fact that I did this alone, it makes me proud because I've never done anything without her. You know, I've done this whole thing not thinking about the prize, but mostly just thinking about making Nadia proud and being like, if she got kicked out first, my torch is going to be the last one out.
The winner of Survivor San Juan del Sur.